And I'm Chief Meteorologist Tony Amalfi. A stormy afternoon today. Many folks sitting in those pictures. Shalisa from Kissimmee, good-looking shot of the ominous skies as storm clouds rolled in earlier today. R.J. Morris down in Point Siena, more of the same. Very heavy rain, and it came in waves. Compliments now this cold front up north and a trough of low pressure. The two will build southward tonight to begin to dry us out. But the rain today, the big story. Gotha, 2.6 inches of rain, Lake Mary almost an inch and a half, and Oakland Point nearly 2 inches of rain. So where it came down fast and furious. 69, less humid, a little bit cooler up towards Ocala. You get to the 408 and the beach line. Overnight low temperatures aren't going to be as cool or as less humid, as that drier air will take a little bit longer time to build from north to south. Speaking of that front, here it is by Wednesday late afternoon on into the evening across southern Brevard, Polk, and Osceola counties. North of that cold front, we're going to be dry, but we're still going to be hot, but not as humid as we've seen the last couple of days. 92 Salt Springs in Ocala, 94 in Eustis. We work our way south and east. Lots of 94s here through Orange, Seminole, Osceola County, on into Polk County as well. Holopaw, you're at 94. And then back towards Palm Bay, Cocoa, and Melbourne. 91, 92 degrees should about do it. Looking ahead to Thursday, front kind of stalls out. Little kink of low pressure develops along the tail end of it. That lifts up to the north. That triggers more afternoon showers and thunderstorms. And overall coverage by Friday will be running a good 50, maybe even potentially as high as 60%. We'll keep you posted on that. And then into the weekend, rain chances remaining high as those sea breezes collide and we get that deep southeasterly flow. Now, switching gears and looking towards the tropics, here's Invest 93, finding a little bit of dry air tonight and still working off towards the west. But we do believe that with time, this will get a little bit better organized as it's moving over warmer waters, and there will be some more moisture, less dry air in its path, so to speak, down the road. So the curvature, all the models in pretty good sync here, moving off towards the west, northwest. Towards the end of the weekend, could be near San Juan, and then potentially lifting north and west of there. We'll, of course, keep you posted. We want you to check back in to get the updates on that. But right now is a great time to download our Hurricane Tracker app. Always have that handy for you to get the very latest information on anything out there this hurricane season in the tropical Atlantic. A good, useful tool to have when you're not watching WESH. Let's take a look now at that updated 7-day forecast. Rain chances on the lower side for a change Wednesday and Thursday, but going right back up Friday, Saturday, and again on Sunday.